Hi friends, in this video I would like to show you on how to check the incomplete assets for fixed assets. So to check the incomplete assets, this has to be done every month and before running the depreciation. So if you use this report, this will be helpful. Before running the depreciation, you know which assets going to give an error. Like the error can be happen, maybe the cost center is missing, or some information in the fixed asset may be missing. So to do this, you need to check the transaction code here. So you have the transaction code is called AUVA. So this is the T code. So the steps to go here using the path is you need to go to the fixed assets and then environment, and then you need to go to the problem analysis. So under the problem analysis, you can check this T code. The transaction is called AUVA. So when you check on this T code, you double click on it. So this T code, you can check incomplete assets by a different criteria. So the criteria can be, you can check for a specific asset class, or asset number or asset sub number. So you have these choice. So if you want to check a specific asset, you can check. And what are the indicators? The level of completion. So the level of completion, you can check by default. The system will show here 1 and 2, 1 to 2. So what are the options available here? So if it is 0 means asset complete, and 1 is asset incomplete, and 2 asset incomplete and cannot be posted depreciation and retirement. So another 1 asset is incomplete, cost center, internal order, activity type are missing. Then the number 4 is asset incomplete, investment accounting. So you can check this report, which will be helpful to see which assets missing. Let's say when you before running the depreciation, if you run this report, this will show which assets is actually giving you an going to give an error when you're running the depreciation. So this will be a very useful report, but for me it won't show anything because there is no asset. So when you click on this, so it will show this report, and this report is possible by the field group, and this is called field group and field group name. And here, let's say if any asset is having a mandatory field, if the users don't fill in, is accidentally save it, then the system will show under here the list of assets is not complete, and which is maybe created via interfaces, or maybe some may be created with the different objects like a purchase order. If it is automatically created, so those sometimes cost center may be missing. So for those cases, this report of incomplete assets in the detail is really helpful. So I would recommend to run this report before you are executing the depreciation run. So this is really helpful report before running the depreciation, which will show here all the incomplete assets. So then you can click on here, then you correct those specific assets, or you can reach out to the users and user who created to update the information what is missing. So the system show what is missing also under here, but currently I don't have any here. So in your real business case and a real system, you will be seeing it and in the system. If the configuration in the backend is available, then the system will clearly show those assets incomplete here. Thank you guys.